Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at an introduction to dienes. So di means two, and ene tells me that I have a double bond. So a diene is going to have two double bonds in it. This is the simplest diene that I've drawn right here, 1,3-butadiene. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4 total carbons, and each of those carbons has a double bond across it. So I've drawn the two conformers of 1,3-butadiene. This one on the left is called the S trans conformer. If it rotated about the bond between carbon 2 and 3, we would get the S cis conformer. The S cis conformer is the higher energy conformer because the H's that are on those terminal carbons, when it's in the S cis conformer, are very close to one another. There's a lot of steric hindrance. And so that's not the preferred conformer. There is a little bit of a rotational barrier around carbon 2 and 3 because you can see in this pi system that I've drawn here, even though there's not a pi bond between carbon 2 and carbon 3, these p orbitals are lined up with one another. So there is some interaction, some delocalization of electrons throughout the pi system. And that creates a little bit more of a rotational barrier between carbon 2 and 3 as you would see in a typical just alkyl system with no pi bonds in it. So in the example we were just looking at, the two double bonds were next door to one another. There was only four total carbons, but of course you could have a diene that had many more carbons than four. In the examples that I've given here, I have six total carbons and two double bonds, and the positioning of those double bonds is different in each case. For this top system, the two double bonds are right next door to one another. They're adjacent to one another. And this is called a conjugated diene. And a conjugated diene is low in energy. It's very stable because it has resonance and conjugation throughout that pi system. So those electrons are delocalized because they're next door neighbors to one another. In the middle example, we would call that an isolated diene. Those two double bonds are isolated from one another by the presence of sp3 hybridized carbons in between them. So there's no way that you could do resonance between this double bond and this double bond because they're not adjacent to one another. They're not delocalized. They're isolated and localized on the two sides of the molecule there. And then the last molecule is called cummulated in the way that its double bonds are sharing a central carbon with one another. And these are very unstable and not very common under standard temperature and pressure conditions. The pi bonds are actually perpendicular to one another, so there's not conjugation here either. You have one set of p orbitals that's above and below the plane, and then one set that's in front and in back of the plane. And so that central carbon is sp hybridized, and those two pi bonds are orthogonal to one another, or in the node of each other. So this is not a particularly stable molecule, and you really don't see it formed very often under standard temperature and pressure conditions. Lastly, once you get to larger ring sizes, you can have double bonds within a ring or just in a chain. So we would refer to double bonds that were part of a chain as acyclic. These particular double bonds, because they're next door, would also be conjugated. So this is a conjugated acyclic diene. Then the middle example, you've got a conjugated diene and it's cyclic. These are in a cyclic system, right? And then lastly, this is also a cyclic system. It's also a diene because those double bonds are inside of a ring, but these would be isolated because you can see that there are sp3 hybridized carbons between them. They're not adjacent to one another. So double bonds can be present in a ring or outside of a ring. They can be conjugated, they can be isolated, they can even be, in some instances, cumulated. So this has been a look at dienes. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.